agus bhuiine legan teirtíineí chuimeid an manachlah agus speicmuid ag míhallú maiartta sibh go bhhaicimiid go dé tab chaáige.
Roi agus tásúla gom gúil siú se bun penna was an sreiseo á leir an gold. I hi é mátatá gin agus cílín sé sin gur cúsaí ó mán atá faoi cabad le gin. 1976 is tonight's year, the weather was fine that year and so was the hurl. Kilkenny began the year as All-Ireland champions and they showed good form by adding the National League to their list of victories. Down in Munster it was 2 in a row for Cork and they had a bye to the All-Ireland final. As usual, Galway represented Connacht in the All-Ireland semi-final, a semi-final that was played in Portkilkenny. But before we'd reached that stage, there was a big shock for Kilkenny, as Wexford beat them comprehensively in the Leinster final. Portkilkenny then, Wexford and Galway in an All-Ireland semi-final which ended in a draw. A little bit of controversy attached to the replay, but eventually Wexford went on to go into the All-Ireland final against Cork. Interestingly, both full forwards, Tony Doden for Wexford and Ray Cummins from Cork, they were the respective captains. Cluhe Marsin go raibh an pobal a thnú leis. Corky agus Lough Garman, mar a bhí sa bhliain éideag a chéad a sé, mar a bhí sa bhliain éideag a chéad a cahar, i gluhe canis na héirn, i bárcha chróca da chotan líon da córi. Mi hálo héir a bhí áon mar sáftra an lá sin leis.
Back in behind, and there at the second row, referee Paddy Johnson getting ready for the throw-in, and the game is on. And Cork into an early attack. Ray Cummins, John Nolan. Confident clearance by John Nolan. Ball battered down there by John Crowley, and added to very quickly there for Cork by Brendan Cummins, but it has gone out over the sideline for a line ball for Wexford, about 5 yards from their own end line, and Kenny O'Connor is going to take it. Shortage one, and the referee penalises Sean O'Leary for a push in the back there, and this will be a free, but I think it'll be a good deal longer. Kenny O'Connor again. Quickly, my mistake, he's wanting all the time. He sends it in and now it comes to John Quigley, the shot that has gone wide. Martin Quigley getting that one, getting it to his brother John, and the shot going wide. Just over a minute gone in the first half, no score. Martin Coleman, with this habit of his of testing the spring of the stick before he takes the puck out. A good one. Nicely held by Mick Jacob. And Wexford in the attack now. Martin Quigley and John Crowley. John Quigley. Martin running onto it now. Nice pass up now to Christy Keogh. This is Brian Murphy for Cork. Under pressure. Still under pressure. And this is Tony Doden. Pass inside. Martin Quigley getting ready, but there's a free in. From Wexford from the 21-yard line, and this could be the first score of the game as Tony Doden put Martin Quigley in there for a chance for a score. He was fouled, and Mick Butler comes out to take it. And here's his shot. It's over the bar, the first score of the game. 2.5 minutes gone, first half, and the scorer, Mick Butler, and that makes it Wexford 1 point, Cork, no score. Mick, incidentally, has scored 2016 points for the Wexford men in the championship until that one. That makes it 2 goals and 17. Put out long comes down in the centre by Billy Rosen. This is Dennis Corlin. Oh, a long one from way out the field, but it's gone wide. Well, the team's not settled down, of course, yet by any means. About 3 minutes gone in this first half. John Nolan going back for the puck out. He tests the swing of the hurley too. John Crowley backing him down. Ned Buckley gets in and Buckley takes a shot that's high and it's gone over the bar. Another point for Wexford. The batting down of the ball by the Cork half back line intended for the centre field went instead to Ned Buckley. Ned made no mistake and after 4 minutes of play, Wexford lead by 2 points to no score. Martin Coleman. Ray Cummins and Willie Murphy. Willie, they're in the gutter of tussle number one and the referee penalises Cork for a tackle on a man who didn't have the ball and there's a free out to be taken by Jimmy Prendergast. Jimmy, who was one of the doubtful members of the Wexford team. Dropping 30 yards out. John Crowley trying to get it up. Martin Quigley likewise. Christy Kyo. Somebody had a shovel to do well in there. Pat Moylan for Cork. Brendan Cummins lets it go by, but Big Jacob comes back with. Nice clearance for Wexford. And the ball gone out over the line. Line ball for Cork, just outside their own 50-yard line. That dropping ball there. Nobody could reach it before it went out over the sideline. Martin Doherty to take the line ball. Oh, a very, very short one. Goes to Johnny Murphy for Wexford. Tony Gordon and Pat McDonald going for it. Pulled out by Pat Barry. Game hasn't really opened up yet, and now Big Butler with the ball. A nice scooping shot that's gone. Oh, hit the upright. Tony Gordon trying to get it in. And it is a goal! A goal by Martin Quigley. A goal by Martin Quigley, sent in first by Tony Gordon with his hand pass effort, and pulled on by Martin Quigley, and here it is again. There's Tony Gordon with the ball, hand passing it into the centre, and it's flicked in to the net by Martin Quigley, and the score is Wexford, 1 goal and 2 points, Cork, no score. A long tuck out. Nick Jacob going away with the ball. Billy Rosen, and it's all Wexford at this stage. Billy Rosen still up the field with that ball. Being chased by Pat Moylan. Christy Kyo. Pat McDonald comes out to Martin Quigley to Tony Jordan. It's only shot and Martin Coleman saves it. Martin Quigley comes back in again and this is another goal. Another goal for Wexford. Wexford blitz as Martin Quigley getting that ball as it came out to him, crashed it into the net and without reply it's Wexford. 2 goals and 2 points. Cork, no score. Ball in now towards the goal. Tony Jordan tries to get it. It comes back out to Martin Quigley. He gets it into Tony Jordan. Tony Jordan's shot saved by Martin Coleman. And out it goes again to Martin Quigley and into the net. And Cork, while we were looking at that, came round and had a wide. Puck out by John Nolan. Ball breaking down, Gerald McCarthy gone back for it. Gerald fouled in possession and a free to Cork. Dennis Collins to take it. And Cork will really have to kick into gear now with this Wexford blitz that's really hit them in the first 7 minutes. Dennis Collins puck. The referee penalises a Wexford man for going too near the taker of the free when it was being taken. And there is another free to Cork. Dennis Collins coming up to take it. It was Johnny Murphy who was too near the ball, and exactly where this free is going to be, well, it's in a much better position. In fact, it's getting better by the second. Pat Boylan is going to take this one just outside the 70-yard line. a wide stance. And it's over the bar. Cork's first score of the game after 8 minutes of play. Pat Boylan from O'Brien making the score now. Wexford 2 goals and 2 points. That's 8 points. Cork 1 point. And Pat Boylan the scorer. John Nolan. Oh, a very, very long one. Come back to get it now, Pat Barry. This one cut down by Johnny Murphy. Breaks it to Mick Butler. John Quigley. Tony Jordan. Tony without his stick, but he's got the ball. Over to Mick Butler. Mick Butler bursting his way through and sending it over, but no. Now the referee has called back the play. And he has blown his whistle, he's called back the play. He's standing on the 21-yard line, and I think it's a free-in, but he had blown the whistle before the score was scored. And he has called back the play and has awarded a free to Wexford from the 21-yard line. Mick Butler to take it. And he sends it over the bar, and there's no mistake about it. Wexford leading, deserving to lead, with the score 2 goals and 3 points. That is 9 points to Cork's solitary 1 score, 1 point. 9.5 minutes gone in the first half. Nobody seemed to know where it was. Ned Buggy did. Nick Jacob. Martin Doherty. With the Pat Boylan. Charlie McCarthy going across to it there. This is Ray Cummins now for Cork. And if one team can hand pass, so can the other. Nick Malone, who's gone across from this wing to that wing. Charlie McCarthy not getting there as quick as Mick Jacob. Gerald McCarthy getting there quickly. His puck knocked down by Jimmy Prendergast in a line ball for Cork. Just outside the Wexford 21-yard line, about 25 yards out, Gerald McCarthy to cut it.
Good ball, yeah?
Jimmy Barry Murphy in now to Mick Malone. Malone trying to get it through. He takes a shot and it's a point. A hand pass point by Mick Malone, making the score 9-2 in favour of Wexford. Fielded Mick going across from the right wing as he's been doing. Here it is again. There's Jimmy Barry Murphy's pass into Malone. Malone trying to get his way through. He loses the stick and palms it over. John Nolan with a long puck out once again. Paddy Barry blocking it down. Gerald McCarthy in under it. And the ball gone off a Wexford man and a line ball for Cork. Ryan Murphy to take it. Lion footballer come harder. Brendan Cummins adding to it. Jimmy Barry Murphy trying to get to it. Ray Cummins across into the centre to Charlie McCarthy all alone. And Charlie sends it over the bar. And I think he tried for a goal. Whatever he tried for, he got a point. A very nice pass by Ray Cummins. And I'm sure Charlie is saying to himself, it should have been a goal. And just look at what the easy shot he had. 21 yards out, nobody near him. He did, I think, shoot for the top of the net. It went too high, and the score is 2-3 to 3 points in favour of Wexford. And what a puck out by John Nolan. 30 yards out. John Quigley. Johnny Murphy. And it's wide. Cork have settled down a good deal better in the last 4 or 5 minutes. The match is 12 minutes old. They've settled down a good deal better in the last 4 or 5 minutes. And after being absolutely out of the game in the very early stages when Wexford really settled down, as they did against Galway in the replay in Porgy Keefe, well, Cork have come back into the game, but they're still trailing and deserve to be trailing at this stage. Pat Barry being robbed there by John Quigley. Barry back for the ball. Brendan Cummins and Ray Cummins. This is Ray. Willie Murphy out after him, and Ray's got inside him now. And Ray is brought down, and there is a penalty for Cork. Dead straight in front of the goal, of course. and it will be taken. Here it is. There is Ray Cummins going through. And, well, photo finish there about the penalty, but penalty it is. Pat Boylan to take it. And if he gets a goal here, how this game will spring to life. That wide stance. He doesn't try for a goal. He's satisfied for a point to show that there's no panic in the Cork quarters, although they are trailing at this stage with the score 9-4, or 2 goals and 3 points for Wexford and 4 points for Cork. Pat Boylan, the scorer, and here's John Nolan with the puck over.
Come on, there you go.
Wexford men getting into one another's way there. Ned Buggy. And the line ball is John Crowley, or Brian Murphy kicked that one out, and he kicked it up, but it went over Wexford man. It was a line ball for Cork. Everybody could take it. Played it full back in the Munster final, playing out of the half line here. Brendan Cummins deflecting it out. Jimmy Prendergast and Charlie McCarthy. Brendan Cummins taking advantage, and Charlie McCarthy has gone down with an injury. Ball right across the goal by Jimmy Barry Murphy. And a lovely interception there by Willie Murphy. Charlie McCarthy, meanwhile, is down injured way up here on the right. Ray Cummins trying to come through with the ball. Willie Murphy after him. The referee penalises the Wexford man for a foul there. And there's a free for Cork on the 21-yard line. And Charlie McCarthy going in to take his position now. He did get a knock on the side of the face there. In fact, I think he's going over to take the free. Showing that, he couldn't have been all that bad. Cork very much back in the game after Wexford went into a whirlwind start there. Some blood on Charlie's nose as he takes this one. And he sends it over the bar. Another point for Cork, scored by Charlie McCarthy after 15 minutes of play. The score is Wexford 2 goals and 3 points, Cork 5 points. So that's Charlie's second point of the game. John Knowles. Dennis Collins getting it down to Pat Moylan. Cork have scored the last 5 scores of this game. And here's Pat Moylan being chased by Johnny Murphy. Jimmy Barry Murphy, Brendan Ray, the whole lot of them in there. Colin Jordan, now Mick Jacob. Mick Jacob getting a nice clearance in. Dennis Collin. And it's brought down and deflected right across the goal mouth. But there's nobody there but a Wexford man. And the Wexford man is John Nolan. Not as confident as usual. Ed Boogie can't get it. Jordan McCarthy does. A dropping ball. It's hit the upright, come back into play. And Charlie McCarthy, amazed at the ball coming out to him there, mishit it. And the ball out pretty near the sideline. This is Shawnee Leary. Bandage, knee and all. That's Colin Gordon. And he's calling, judging the hop of the ball perfectly there. John Nolan, the referee going up, the linesman has put his, not the linesman, but the umpire has put his hand up and has given a signal and indeed has also given a message to the referee, and there is a 21-yard free because the goalkeeper lay on the ball, I would say. And here it is, there it is. The goalkeeper, in fact, sitting on the ball, and isn't he a plucky boy? Pat Moylan to take the free, and it was a foul on the ball. It is not a penalty. It's an ordinary free in hurling. Here's the free anyway, taken by Pat Moylan, and it's sent over the bar. A foul on the ball inside the small square is not a penalty in hurling. That is the third point for Pat Moylan, as Wexford being 2 goals and 3 points to Cork 6 points. And the rather dreary opening to this game has really disappeared and has been replaced by what we all thought it would be. Gerald McCarthy. will have caught 7 points. And the last score was for Wexford was 2-3 to 1 point way back after 9.5 minutes of play, and we're now in the 18th minute of play. So Wexford had better get into gear, as we said about Cork earlier on. Three to Cork, inside their own 70. Pat Moylan, with all the care of an Eddy care. It has gone over the bar for a point by Pat Moylan, and a lovely free from way out the field, his fourth of the game, and now there's only 1 point between them. Wexford 2-3, Cork 8 points. John Dolan, who hasn't let a goal in there, those Cork scores are all points. Ned Buggy getting the ball upfield, but it's out over the line for a line ball for Cork. John Quigley top of the left, Christy Keogh left half forward on the Wexford team. This is Brian Murphy. Brendan Cummins, Billy Rosen, Paddy Barry, John Crowley, Martin Quigley dipping in now, and Martin's being chased by Gerald McCarthy, and he's still on his way. And a nice point there. Hold it. The referee had blown his whistle. And there is a free out for Cork for carrying the ball too far. And this free will be taken by Pat McDonald just outside the Cork 21-yard line. About 25 yards, I would say. Dean Bennett under it. Jimmy Barry Murphy gets the ball in a bit nearer. Willie Murphy, hand up at the right time. Paddy Barry, Gerald McCarthy. Dean Bennett coming across. In there too, Billy Wilson. Colum Gordon coming down now to be chased by Charlie McCarthy. Pat McDonald putting his hand up and grabbing that ball. Had a great deal of distance, and Willie Murphy jugging it well. Christy Keogh now getting to the sideline, over the line, line ball for Cork. Correction, line ball for Wexford. Went off Pat Barry. Ed Buggy. And Tony Jordan's got it into his hand, but he's grounded. Dennis Paulin, and Tony is down stretched at the moment, as you can see. Seemed to get a knock on the back of the neck. Or was it? Here it is anyway. Here it is again. Tony Jordan with the ball. And along the back of the neck there, as you could see. And here is the free. It's taken by Mick Butler, and it's sent over the bar, putting Wexford further ahead. Mick Butler's third point of the game. Of the score now, Wexford 2 goals and 4 points, Cork 8 points. If you prefer, the total in points, 10 points to 8. 22 minutes gone, first half. Jimmy Barry Murphy trying to get the ball away from Billy Rosen. And Liam Bennett in there too. Talk about stalemate. That's Ned Buggy. Gerald McCarthy. How did he get that one up? Pat Boylan. And a lovely shot from out the field. Oh, a beautiful point there by Pat Boylan. From way out of the far side of the field. Right out on the sideline. And now there's only 1 point between them again. 2 goals and 4 points to 9 points. Wexford leading by 1 point after over 23 minutes of play in the first half. John Crowley, Jimmy Barry Murphy, Brendan Cummins, but beaten by an incoming Mick Jacob. Line ball for Cook. Just outside the Wexford 50-yard line, and Pat Moylan gone across to take. Delightful ball. Johnny Leary getting it across in front of the goal, and it's gone off. Somebody's kicking dog wide. Johnny Leary is arguing that it is a 70, and the umpires don't want to know. On the puck out, Gerry McCarthy. O'Connor into Ned Buggy. What a wonderful delivery he has. Pat McDonald and Tony Gordon. Pat McDonald gone back with Mick Butler, and the ball gone over the line off the Corkman, and it's a 70. John Murphy has gone centre field for Wexford, and Billy Rostrom has gone right half forward. That's a switch in the Wexford team. And this is Ned Buggy, who is quite an expert at these 70s, to take this one. Not a puff of wind to disturb him. And straight over the bar, a lovely point there by Ned Buggy, making the score now. Wexford leading by 2 goals and 5 points to Cork's 9 points. Jimmy Barry Murphy, right half forward. Mick Malone, left half forward. In fact, Jimmy Barry Murphy, right half forward, and Mick Malone, left half forward on the Cork team, and that's another switch. And mention of Jimmy Barry Murphy, there he is. Ned Buggy getting there first with that one. Dennis Collin, but the ball gone off his stick, line ball for Wexford. Ian Bennett, who was a doubtful starter before the game, to take this line ball for Wexford just inside their 50-yard line. Asking that the ball be taken out of a little hole, and it must be a little one. Certainly it was worth the journey. Nice bit of high football-like fielding by Dennis Collin, Brendan Cummins, Ray beaten by Jimmy Prendergast, wholehearted Jimmy. And the hand is up again, and it's Tony Gordon to John Quigley, but intercepting there Brian Murphy, and the ball eventually cleared out by John Crowley. Wexford back pressing now. After dominating the first 4 or 5 minutes of the game, they've been trailing the Corkmen, not on the scoreboard, but in the play, and in the last few minutes now have been coming back to dominance again. Nice line ball by Ned Buggy. Mick Butler. And you don't shoulder Mick Butler too easily. Pat Moylan, Mick Malone and Liam Bennett together, with the ball gone on past them. And this is Brendan Cummins. Ray and Willie Murphy. Charlie McCarthy and Jim Prendergast and Willie Murphy coming in. What a great player this is. Work there by Gerald McCarthy, but the referee eventually penalizes them and awards a 3-2 Wexford, just about 60 yards out from the Cork goal and about 2 yards in from the near sideline. And now it is about 55 yards out from the Cork goal and about 5 yards in from the near sideline. Ned Buggy.
That's a good ball.
Patrick Coleman let it fall, but he got it out very quickly. I think the proximity of another defender may have cut his eye there, but he did get it out. Line ball now. Johnny Murphy to take it for Wexford. Passing it back to the wandering Christy Keogh. Christy's shot is wide, and the score remains Wexford 2-5. That is 11 points, Cork 9 points. 28 minutes gone in the first half. Christie coming back now to his own left wing. Martin Cole. Goal and about 35 yards out from it, and Ned Buggy to take it. And writers of scores are ready already, and very right, it's over the bar. Another point, Ned Buggy's third of the game. That makes it Wexford 2 goals and 6 points to Cork's 9 points. Ned, who has played in the half back line, playing at centre field today, half an hour gone in this first half. Oh, a very long puck out. And Jimmy Barry Murphy grabbed it. Knocked away off his stick by Colin Gordon. Out to Pat Boylan. Ray Cummins. Getting inside this time. A kick and a goal! Ray Cummins, footballer from Hurler. And he's proved it. Breaking through. Here it is now. Getting the ball up. Getting inside Willie Murphy. Losing his stick in transit, not a hesitant, not a moment's hesitancy there, crashing it into the net, and the play back now at the other end of the field as Wexford attack. The score. The side's level, 12 points each, but the Wexford attack broken up now by Mick Malone coming up the field. The ball hit off his stick, in comes Mick Jacob, and Mick Jacob doing what the Cork fan did. Out to John Quigley, who's moved out into the half line again. Tony Gordon coming out for it, but doesn't get to it. Brian Murphy, out to John Crowley. Jimmy Barry Murphy. Adam Gordon getting there ahead of him. Pat Boyle. John Crowley, Martin Quigley after him. Mick Malone, I don't know whether he contacted with that one or not, but the intention was good. Gone back is Teddy O'Connor. His puck is dropped down by Shawnee Leary. Shawnee's shot is high, and Cork have gone into the lead for the first time in the game. After 31 minutes of play, Shawnee Leary coming across from the far side with the ball on his stick, getting a good position and putting Cork ahead 110 to 26 after 32 minutes of play. And back come Wexford now, but their attack broken up. Gerald McCarthy, Mick Malone, Ray Cummins coming down with Willie Murphy after him. This is Charlie McCarthy now. Point for Cork, Charlie McCarthy coming out from his corner to about 30 yards out and sending it over to put Cork 2 points ahead with about 2.5 minutes left in this first half. 2-6 is the Wexford goal, but Cork are leading with 1-11, 1-11 to 2-6. And Christy Kill, back to Martin Quigley. John Crowley. And there's a free to Wexford just inside the Cork 70 yard line, and the free will be taken by Ned Buggy. Deflected, and the referee, the playing away up the field, the ball was deflected by John Crowley. The referee seemed to have the idea that he was standing too near the ball, but it certainly didn't look it from up here. from down on the ground, but not from up here, and you can hear the crowd's reaction to it. Ned Buggy to take the free again. And Ned Buggy makes no mistake this time, sends it straight over the bar. And so as we approach the half-time with about 2 minutes, less than 2 minutes left in the game, there is only 1 point between them. Ned Buggy the score of 4 for Wexford, the score Cork 1-11, Wexford 2-7. Up goes Tony Jordan. Pat McDonald, Tony Jordan again. Pat McDonald again. Martin Quigley, Tony Jordan. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. And the last ball was Dennis Corlin, and it's a line ball for Wexford. Wexford pressing now in the last minute of the first half. They trail by 1 point at this stage, after dominating the very early stages of the game. Ned Buggy. And he's got it again. I don't know how he does it, but it is Tony Jordan trying to pay volleyball or something with it there in the ground, but not succeeding. This is Big Jacob. Ned Buggy. That ball did a skid when it hit the ground there. Racing out for it now is Tony Dolan. And he's gone through. But the ball knocked off his stick by Pat McDonald. Now John Quigley trying to get through. Pat Barry stands in his way. But Pat takes out there. John takes the shot and the sides are level. And they'd be going in for halftime in any moment. The score now, Cork, 1 goal and 11 points. Wexford, 2 goals and 8. 14 points each, and I make it 35 minutes gone in the first half. Referee looking at his watch, and there is the halftime whistle. And so, after an entertaining, if not brilliant, first half, the sides are level. The level is 14 points each. Eamon O'Donoghue, top of the left, for Cork instead of Shawnee Cleary. The game is on, and 35 minutes away from glory for somebody. Mick Malone. And Brendan Cummins takes a shot that goes wide. It looked a scorable chance from up here, but a lot of things look a lot of things from up here. John Nolan with the puck out. Wexford playing from left to right. John Murphy, chased by Pat Boylan. Murphy nicely up now. John Quigley tries to get through Martin Doherty, which isn't exactly an easy way to go. And Tony Jordan has it, and it's a goal! A goal for Wexford! Another Tony Jordan special! Don't let anybody ask how he does it. He does it! And look at him laying down the law now. Wexford 3-8, Cork are 1-11. Here it is again. He has it in his hand. And the shot that's low, Martin Coleman dives for it, can't get to it, and it's wide. Right, not wide, but right into the net, I should say. 17-14. Wexford leading 3-8 to 1-11. Morgan out, far side of the field. Line ball for Wexford to be taken by Colum Jordan. Colum Jordan to take it. Colum, who's a brother of Tony's, of course.
Substitution on the court team.
Nick Muggy gambling with that one across. The gamble didn't come off, and it's Mick Malone now. And Mick Malone fouled, and the referee calls back the play and awards a free to Cork. Pat Boylan to take it. Boylan standing over the ball now, and he sends it over for a point for Cork and narrowing the gap again. And it is Wexford 3 goals and 8 points, Cork 1 goal and 12, 17 to 15 in favour of the Wexford men after 2.5 minutes of the second half. John Crowley, General McCarthy, Brendan Cummins, Charlie McCarthy, a goal! A goal by Charlie McCarthy! Charlie coming across from the far side of the field, a typical Charlie McCarthy goal, running across from the right, just watch it again now, as it comes in from Brendan Cummins, across comes Charlie there on the right, judges the hop, lets it hop again, and crashes it into the net, and John Nolan hasn't a chance. Back live again, and play is in the centre of the field. The score is Cork 18 points, Wexford 17, 2-12 to 3-8 in favour of Cork. And there is a free on the far side of the field for Cork, 70 yards out from their own goal. Pat Moylan going across to take it. Almost 4 minutes gone in the second half. Only a point between them. They're waiting for the ball to be retrieved. Into the goal mouth. John Nolan under pressure, getting it out. Brendan Cummins. Charlie McCarthy under it with Jim Prendergast. Prendergast up into the centre of the field. Pat Moylan going back to recover. And it's a line ball for Wexford. Just outside their own 50-yard line. Ned Buggy, taker in chief of line ball and the like. And Tony Jordan racing onto the ball now. Martin Quigley. A point, and the sides are level. It was Martin Quigley who eventually got it out and sent it over the bar. 18 points each. Cork 2-12, Wexford 3-9. That's 2 goals and a point scored by Martin Quigley. 5 minutes gone in the second half. And the puck out by Martin Coleman, all the way out over the line, nobody touching. Out from their own goal. Ned Buggy. Pat Moylan trying to get to it, but it's John Quigley who moves over now onto the right half position again. Ball heading towards the sideline. It's just dribbled over. Line ball for Wexford, 55 yards out from their own goal. Jimmy Prendergast and John Horgan is coming into the Cork team. And this is not a surprise by any means. In fact, a lot of people thought it was a surprise he wasn't there all the time. Pat Barry has gone off and John Horgan has come on. John Crowley has gone right half back and John Horgan centre half back. That's Gerald McCarthy and Martin Quigley together there, but there is a free against Martin Quigley for the Cork man just inside their own 70. The sides level at 18 points each. Pat Moylan. Pat Moylan's free. Jimmy Barry Murphy got a bit of a knock there, but the referee blows his whistle and the walls are free. Two Cork dead straight in front of the goal. Christy Kyo has gone off the Wexford team. We'll sort out the sub in just a moment. We'll follow the play here as Pat Moylan comes up with an effort to put the Cork men into a one-point lead. And he does, he sends it over the bar, a point, putting Cork 1 point ahead now after 8 minutes of play in the second half. Cork, 2 goals and 13 points. Wexford, 3 goals and 9. That's the 7th point for Pat Moylan. And Declan Rosom, the other Rosom twin, is on the field. So, Declan and Winnie out there of the Rosoms for the Wexford men. As Cork lead by 1 point. This is Colin Jordan under pressure. This is Mick Jake. Oh, a lovely dropping ball, but it's too high. It looked like a dangerous one, but it was going to drop in the vicinity of the square. It didn't, and it went wide. 19-18 in favour of Cork. Oh, what a lovely bit of fielding there by Mick Jacob.
On, Quigley.
And the referee penalises John Quigley for a foul pull there. And the referee just having a word with him. And there is a free 2 Cork from 70 yards out from the Wexford goal as Dennis Collin is down injured. And Martin Casey is coming on the Wexford team, or is it? It is. Martin Casey is coming on the Wexford team. And we'll sort out who's gone off in just a moment. Martin Casey is on. Dennis Collin is all right anyway, but here is Pat Boylan to take the free. It's high. It's hit the upright. That's 2 balls that hit the upright during the game. The ball comes back out to Jimmy Barry Murphy, and he sends it over the bar. Jimmy Barry Murphy, the scorer of that one, and that makes the score now Cork 2-14 and Wexford 3-9. And Billy Rosom is gone off the Wexford team. The other twin, Declan, is on. Almost 11 minutes gone in the second half. It's 20 points for Cork, 18 for Wexford. Line ball. Led Buggy to take it for Wexford. That's the 70-yard line. To him, he gets it outside the parallelogram, let there be no doubt about it. He got that ball outside the parallelogram and has palmed it into the net, and now the score is Wexford 4-19, that's 21 points, Cork 2-14, that's 20 points, 20-21, and here come Cork again, Eamon O'Donoghue, Teddy O'Connor after him, and the ball gone in and wide. 1 point between them, Wexford leading 21-20. 12 minutes, almost 13 gone in the second half. John Crowley batting the ball down again into the centre field, Ed Buggy. This is Martin Doherty, 3 Wexford men around him. The one that got after him there and forced him out over the line, Martin Quigley. Line ball for Wexford. Dean Bennett. Declan Rosen trying to get it up. John Horgan. Gerald McCarthy. Phil Gerald. Moylan. And it's gone wide. And there are switches all round the place here. Brendan Cummins has gone top of the right. Charlie McCarthy, left half forward. Jimmy Barry Murphy is right half forward. Mick Malone, centre half forward for Cork. And this is John Crowley coming upfield now, being chased by Declan Rosen, who is penalised for chopping, and there's a free to Cork. And with the fair-haired Black Rock band, John Horgan with the free. Pulled on by Jimmy Barry Murphy into Charlie McCarthy. Eamon O'Donoghue on the 21. It's high, but it's wide, it's wide. And Wexford still lead by this 1 point. .49 to .214. 14 minutes gone. And the puck out goes straight out. Playing a little bit of leapfrog over there. Puck out gone straight out over the line for a line ball for Cork. Declan Rosen has come over now at right half forward, and John Quimby gone top of the left for Wexford. Everybody's switching with the game poised so closely, just on the old-fashioned razor's edge. Any move could be a winning one. Line ball for Cork. Jerry McCarthy. Mick Malone now. He sends it in, and he sends it wide. That's two chances Cork have had in the last couple of minutes to equalise. Wexford still leading by 1 point, 21-20. 4-9 to 2-14. John Nolan with the puck out. Ryan Murphy at full back now. Pat McDonald at right full back for Cork. John Horgan's being close to Ned Buggy. Ned's shot is high, and Tony Jordan just doesn't get to it in time, and it's gone wide. He certainly tried valiantly to get up to that one. Well, Brian Murphy now has the job of watching one Anthony Dorn. As Pat McDonald has moved out to right fullback, and John Quigley is his opposite number. And a very long puck out. Mick Malone. Jim Prendergast. Willie Murphy. John Quigley, Tony Jordan, and the hand. No hurley, but the hand. And this is Mick Butler. Mick Butler losing the hurley too. John Horgan back there. Martin Coleman getting the ball on the hop. And under pressure, gearing it out for a line ball for Wexford. And just see how near it was here. That went very near the ground. And the goalkeeper also near the ground there with that ball. We're back live in action now, and it's Wexford coming in with Tony Jordan with the ball. His puck knocked down by Jerry McCarthy. Ryan Murphy. And Ned Buggy with only half a stick, but penalised for pushing in the back there, and there's a free out for Cork. Wexford still leading 1 point, 21-20. Almost 17 of the 35 minutes gone in this second half. That's McDonald way downfield, and pretty nicely feed to them by Colum Gordon. Joined to Tony, isn't the only one that can get the ball into his hand. It's going through with the ball, but is Johnny Murphy, Mick Butler, and Dennis Paulin absolutely throwing himself at Mick Butler there, and Cork a little bit lucky that they didn't concede penalty in there, but they did concede the 70. 21-20, Wexford leading. Ned Buggy coming across to take the 70. Referee being asked by Ned Buggy, can I place it again? And he does. And for one that anything missed at a game like this, 21-20, can be valuable, no matter which end of the field it's on. Martin Coleman. Very long come out again. 30 yards out from the Wexford goal. Mick Malone, Mick Jacob. Jimmy Barry Murphy, of course, there was Teddy O'Connor for Wexford. And the referee penalising Teddy O'Connor for holding the ball too long. And there's a free in for Cork, and this can be the equaliser. Pat Boylan or Charlie McCarthy, it's Pat Boylan who's going to take it. You can see exactly the spot in which it is. Pat bidding for his 8th point of the game. And he makes no mistake, sends it over, and the sides are level again after almost 19 minutes of play in the second half. Cork 21 points, Wexford 21 points, 4-9, 2-15, call it what you like, they're level. Penalising Cork for a holding foul there, and there's a free for Wexford on the 21-yard line and right out. You can see, well, we'll just see how far out it is eventually placed. Just outside the 21-yard line, and it has come in an inch or two. Ned Buggy to take it. And Ned sends it over for the lead for Wexford again. Ned Buggy the scorer. Wexford 22 points, Cork 21, and that is 5 for Ned Buggy, who's certainly having a sharp shooting game. Wexford 4-10, Cork 2-15. Now Martin Quigley, full forward, Tony Dorton, centre half bowler for Wexford. Nice bit of feed in there by Mick Jacob, who catches as many almost as Tony Dorton. Mick Jacob into a loose and waiting Ned Buggy. Johnny Murphy getting it. Martin Coleman. Not a very long clearance. Pat Boylan being tackled. Ball going on the loose to Declan Wilson. Declan wide. Martin Casey. Priest, who's stationed in Ashford, heading out towards Lourdes with a group on Friday. No doubt saying a few appropriate preparatory prayers as he waits for this dropping ball to come out between himself and Pat Boylan. Wexford leading 22-21. Ned Buggy.
John Quigley.
John Quigley. Back to Johnny Murphy. Tony Jordan's waiting inside for it. It's got to him. He gets inside John Horgan, and here he goes. He's going to pass it. He does. Out to the wing. There Declan Rosen gets it. Declan's put locked down by Martin Doherty. And Mick Butler now. A shot that's got over the bar. A point. A point by Mick Butler. And the lead, an increased lead for the Wexford men, who now lead by 23-21. And that is a total of 1 goal and 4 points for Mick Butler. 4-11 for Wexford, 2-15 for Cork. 23-21, 22 minutes gone. The sun beaming down now, shining right in the eyes of the Wexford defence. Gerald McCarthy. Mick Malone. Trying to get it into Jimmy Barry Murphy. That's Colin Gordon. But it goes out, and it's a line ball for Cork. John Crowley's going to take it. More switches in the Cork team. Martin Doherty going out centre half forward and John Horgan going back left full forward. Or the full back, I should say. Martin Doherty centre half back, John Horgan left full back. And a very poorly taken line ball that comes into the waiting John Quigley. John Quigley right up with it and the ball hopped dangerously. John Horgan hooshed off the ball there by Martin Quigley. This is Tony Dorden and the referee going up and awarding a free to Wexford from the 21-yard line. Free to Wexford, 21-yard line. Mick Butler to take it, looking for 1-5 in his tally. He's got 1-4 already. Or will he try for anything else? He does try for something else, does he? John Horgan. This is Pat Gordon now, coming away, but no, he's beaten. John Quigley now for Wexford. John Crowley for Cork. Charlie McCarthy. Ray Cummins is inside him. Charlie takes a shot and he sends it wide. And the score remains Wexford 4-11. That is 23 points. Cork 2-15. That's 21 points. 11 minutes left in the game. Martin Coleman, the goalkeeper, being harassed by Martin Quigley, who, while he blocks down Martin Coleman's shot, he sends it over the end line and was a puck out for Cork. And the way Martin Coleman is pucking them, this one is going to wind up down about 25 yards out from the Wexford goal. Jimmy Barry Murphy full forward for Cork now. And Mick Malone right half forward, Ray Cummins out in the centre half forward position. In fact, the goalkeepers are about the only men where they started. That's an exaggeration, but you get the general drift of switches all around the place by both teams. 10 minutes left in the game, 2 points between them. Wexford leading by two. Ray Cummins can't quite hold to it. And this is Pat Boylan. Pat Boylan, but no, the referee has blown the whistle and called back the play. Referee has blown the whistle, has called back the play. The Cork man a bit disturbed that he didn't let the man in possession go on, but he did blow the whistle and has awarded a free to Cork. Pat Boylan to take it, and this should be all the same anyway, because he got a point a moment ago, and I'm sure he's going to get one now. He has, straight over the bar, and now there's only the 1 point for him. Cork, 23 points. Wexford 23 points, Cork 22. 9 points for Pat Boylan. And whatever happens today, the man with the nine in his back has certainly done his stuff. He's got 9 points already for Cork. And here come Wexford in the attack again. Pat McDonald. Nick Malone and Colin Gordon. Ray Cummins right in to the waiting Mick Jacob. Tony Gordon's gone back in full forward, I see. John Horgan out now towards Dennis Corlin. Dennis will towards his own goal. A bit of messing there that has come off from Cork. Martin Doherty is the man in possession. And then Gerald McCarthy is intercepted. Gerald chasing after it. Now Pat McDonald, there's a certain looseness that's come into the play everywhere now. Nick Jacob way up the field for Wexford. And Tony Dorden, forager in chief. Brian Murphy is out there after him. Martin Doherty is out there. So also is Martin Quigley. The ball comes in from Johnny Murphy and has gone over the end line and wide. John Horgan hurrying things up, throwing the ball to Martin Coleman for the puck out. 1 point between them, 23 to 22. Wexford the leaders. 8 minutes still left in the game. Jimmy Barry Murphy has come out again to the half line. Ray Cummins has gone in full forward. Ned Buggy. John Horton now. He's chased by Nick Butler.
Now come in, Horton.
There's no holding. Messing coming round all round the place there, but that quickly cleared up by Pat MacDonald. Jimmy Barry Murphy breaking away now. He's coming to the 21-yard line. He takes his shot on the side. They're level. Jimmy Barry Murphy breaking away there from that ball. And you don't give Jimmy Barry a chance like that. He sent it over and the sides are level with 7 minutes left in the game. 23 points each. And here it is again. There he goes. Ball on his stick. On the 21. Takes his shot over the bar. No doubt whatever. And the referee awards a free to Cork from just inside their own 50-yard line over on the far side of the field. Just over 28 minutes gone. John Crowley. Jimmy Barry Murphy again. And Jimmy Barry with the lead for Cork. Jimmy Barry snatching up two goals there very, very quickly and sending that one over to put Cork ahead by 1 point. With, what, just over 6.5 minutes left in the game. Cork 24, Wexford 23. That's 2:18 to 4:11. And here come Wexford back again. Dennis Poland trying to break up the attack. Martin Casey is in there. Johnny Murphy is in there. And he's the one in possession. Johnny McCarthy after it. The ball comes back to Lee Bennett. A lovely lob and dropping ball. Martin Coleman. Down the far side of the field now, very near the sideline. Mick Jacob for Wexford. Wexford trailing now by the 1 point. Comes out now to Declan Rosom. Declan shot. It's another one of these lobbing Doran directed ones. Comes down. Scooped out there dramatically by Martin Doherty. Mick Butler. Intercepted by John Horgan. And Mick Jacob, how he catches that ball, I do not know, but he does. And the thundering Dennis Collin thundering upfield with the ball. A dangerous hopping one, John Nolan. Missing that one with the incoming Ned Buggy. They come in breaking through now. In front of the goal, a shot, and it's gone wide. They come in breaking through what looked like a sure score, but it went wide. And Cork lead 24 to 23, and we make it less than 5 minutes left in the game. Pat Moylan. Ray Cummins again breaking through. A kick this time and he scores this one. He sent that one over the bar from a kick. And that's the second kick score of Ray Cummins today. Here he is breaking through. Willie Murphy after him. He takes his kick and over the bar with it. Showing that, well, he still retains his football ability. Cork leading by 2 points, 4 minutes left in the game. Dennis Collin, the kick of the puck knocked down. Mick Butler, John Horgan is after him. And out comes John Horgan, showing that, well, he's really worth it out there. Out comes the ball to Ray Cummins. Ray Cummins to Jimmy Barry Murphy. Jimmy Barry Murphy, the screw shot, and it's gone over the bar for a point. Another one by Jimmy Barry Murphy. And with 4 minutes left in the game, Cork now lead by 3 points. 26 points to Wexford's 23. 26 to 23, the ball gone out over the line. A line ball for Cork, I should say, just inside their own 50-yard line. And nobody wants to take it. Nobody wants to take it. And John Horgan is now called out to take it, and he's telling somebody to move back and cover off his man. And don't dilly-dally on the way, is what they say. Gerald McCarthy getting to the ball. Martin Casey. Gerald McCarthy again. This is Martin Doherty. The ball knocked off his stick there by the wholehearted Martin Quigley. Line ball for Cork. Dennis Collin to take it. 3 minutes from the final whistle, 3 points between them. Jimmy Perry Murphy breaking away now, being chased by Mick Jacobs and by Colum Jordan. Jimmy Barry takes his shot, and again the ball has hit the upright. That's four cracks at the upright. The referee penalising Ray Cummins for picking the ball off the ground, and a free out for Wexford. And there'll be no dilly-dally here, I can assure you. John Nolan with this one, way up the centre. Declan Rosen. Or no, it's Martin Quigley. Back to Martin Casey, a high one out towards the left. And he's got it. Tony Jordan's got the ball. He's trying to work his way through. He's brought down. And the referee has blown his whistle and is calling for the ball. A free for Wexford on the 21-yard line. It is not a penalty. It's a free. It was not inside the parallelogram. In fact, it's not a free. The referee is going to hop it. Referee is going to hop it. From the hop, the ball goes right through to Pat McDonald. That was a relief for Cork indeed. Out comes Ray Cummins now with the ball. Being chased by Mick Jacob. Eamon O'Donoghue. John Nolan. And he's robbed. Eamon O'Donoghue. And again the ball has hit the upright. But it's not out of the woods yet for Wexford. Stalemate down there. And the referee running down from the centre of the field. And I think if he hopped one up there, I'd say he'd hop another down here. He's going to hop this one, going to throw it in. And from each side. Mick Malone to get it. Off his stick by Colin Gordon, and the referee going over again and awarding a free to Cork for penalising Colin Gordon for that pull around Mick Malone. We're in the dying moments of the game. Cork 26, Wexford 23. 2 goals and 20 to Wexford 4-11. Pat Boylan walking over now to take the free, which is just lining up over now. And he sends it over the bar. And that is the absolute insurance point as Pat Boylan, scoring his 10th point of the game, has made the score now. Cork 27, Wexford 23, and there goes the final whistle. And the All-Ireland champions are Cork. And it certainly was a titanic game. A game full of thrills and of excitement and of fine hurling. And Wexford, I know, will, for kingdom come, argue that they should have got a free in the dying moments of the game. They didn't, and the scoreboard reads Cork 27, Wexford 23, or Cork 2 goals and 21 points, Wexford 4 goals and 11. And there is absolute mayhem out of the ground, the right kind of mayhem, as the Cork supporters come in to hug the Cork team who have won them their 22nd All-Ireland. And now if Ray can get his breath, we'll be hearing from the captain of the Cork team.
We the Corky, Nimer on Largumsa, Ockwill, Fira Zorin, Kernsha, Corn McCarry, Exaka Harness, Corky. Ladies and gentlemen, I have very little to say except that we're very glad to be going back with this cup tonight. I'd like to thank everybody involved in this preparation of this team. I'd like to thank in particular today the Wexford team, who gave us just a fantastic game, a fine, clean, sporting game. Now, three cheers for Wexford. Hip hip, hooray! Hip, hip. Hip, hip.